Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and we're talking about pro tennis players I've had contact with all these years as a pastor, as a missionary, someone who's just a friend to reach out to them to share the love of Christ with them. Peng Shuai, her ranking today is around 25 in the world. She's the number two player from mainland China behind Na Li. She always does well. She plays a game where she gets into the quarterfinals or the third or fourth round of a top-level tournament. She hasn't really been able to get into the finals on a consistent basis. I'd like to share a little bit about her. She was the first player to break out of the Chinese tennis system in the modern era. I was around when that happened. She actually did not, she was not talking or associating with the other players from China, and who were also good players, and they would walk by each other. They wouldn't say hello to each other. They wouldn't communicate at all. She sat in one place, the other ones, and they never had any contact. So that was very odd when you think about it, because here they are, you know, from the same country and top level players. But that's the way the system was. The China Tennis Federation probably had a policy in place to stop any communication with someone who broke out of their system. And so that's the way it was. So she ended up going to a tennis academy in Florida where she was being trained, and she was living full time. And you know, once you broke out of the system, you were on your own. You had no money to support you. It's amazing that she could get visas to get out of China to me, because even the Chinese Tennis Federation can stop visas if they probably want to. But she was able to travel on the tour. She was able to get out. And once she stood up, she said, I'm not going to be part of the federation because they're taking all my money from my pro tour prize winnings. The Chinese Tennis Federation was in the press around the world because of that. And so here they, you know, here she was making hundreds of thousands of dollars. And they were taking 100% of her prize money. Now their rationale for that was that they would they trained her since she was a kid, and they paid all of her expenses and they took care of everything for her. But then what happened was that she wanted to keep her money, you know, at some point, and she wanted to have her own coaches, not the federation coaches, who were not really professional level coaches for the pro tour. They were local, they were Chinese coaches who hadn't really played the pro tour. So here Peng Shuai made that decision, and after about a month she had to come back into the media room and say, I apologize to the Chinese Tennis Federation. I was wrong to do that. I decided to join back to the federation. Now what happened was that was really against her will. She decided not to do that, not to break away, and I'm guessing it had to do because they probably came to her and put a lot of pressure on her in some ways. It could have had to do with refusal to get visas to travel out of the country. Perhaps come back into China and you're not able to leave the country. You know, I wasn't privy to those kind of discussions, but what I can tell you is it was so extremely different that I have feeling that she had a lot of pressure on her. And she lasted a few months. She wasn't particularly well liked by the other players because of her stand, and also she has a kind of a strong personality. And she that lasted a few months where she was in the Chinese Tennis Federation, and then she went back to the academy that she was at in Florida with a coach from Taiwan, a Chinese-speaking coach from Taiwan, and he lined up different coaches with her to work with her from different countries. He was trying to make a name for himself among the tennis world, Chinese-speaking tennis world. And one of the coaches that she was involved with became physically involved with her. I saw it myself. And so what happened was that, you know, that completely, here she was coming from a country where people trust each other, you could say, put into a situation where she's by herself, and her mother travels with her very infrequently. She's not really a tennis player. I've met her mother. And that relationship was very destructive to Peng Shuai, because it was about this coach keeping his job. And I happen to have spoken to the coach. So, you know, he needed to keep his job. And that's one of the best ways you can keep a job, is have a relationship with your player. physically. And that lasted a very short period of time, and that relationship stopped. And she was a mess for a number of, I would say at least one, maybe 2 years. She was emotionally a mess, and her ranking went way down. Now she's recovered her ranking. She stopped working with that academy in Florida, but now she's back with the people who are associated with that academy, but not that coach she had the relationship with. And so, you know, she's made a bit of a strong recovery. I've been giving her Christian material for years. I've sat down when she was with Michael Chang. I spoke to Michael at Wimbledon, and he told me, yeah, he coached her, and he was able to show her a DVD, a Christ-centered DVD. But, you know, he didn't really have a strong missions heart, you could say, to reach the players of China. For whatever reason, he hasn't really done that, and he has opportunities for sure to do that. But that was the situation, and I talked to her about coaching with Michael too. I showed her a DVD of the Jesus movie in Mandarin Chinese. I showed her Olympic about Christian athletes who are playing the Olympics. And I've done my part to reach out to her, but she's been surrounded with different people. Some of them are not very healthy for her. And then there are Christians who have come around her, like Michael and myself, and I've given her material. So we just need to pray for Peng Shuai. She's someone who's an outsider to the system to this day, but she's their number two player, and she's a very good player with a great future. So let's continue to lift up Peng Shuai.